Here are the difference between tasks and functions in Systemverilog. All the statements in the body of a function should execute in one simulation time unit. That means, a function cannot have a time-consuming statements in it. But a task can contain time-controlling statements in it. Because of this reason, functions are synthesizable but tasks are not. Therefore, you should use only functions in design coding. Because of the same first reason, a function cannot call a task in it, but a task can call other tasks and functions. Next difference is a function can return a single value to the calling point at its end, but a task cannot return a value. Therefore, non-void function can be used as an operand in an expression, and the value of that operand will be the value returned by the function. In general, functions are extensively used in both design and test bench coding, but tasks are used only in test bench coding. Tasks in Systemverilog. Even though tasks are not synthesizable in general and not recommended to use in design coding, it is good to know how to define a task for a design engineer, as they are extensively used in verification coding. Here is the general structure of a task and it is similar to that of a function. Use the keyword task and endtask instead of function and endfunction. Note that there is no return type for a task as it cannot return a value. The rules for argument list same as that of a function, and the direction specification like input and output are common in task argument list. Also note that the return statement in a task can be added only to stop its execution before the last statements in it, and you will not see them in tasks in general. Here is a simple example of defining a task. A task can contain time-consuming statements and other task calls in it. Pass by reference. Like software programming languages, Systemverilog also supports two ways passing arguments between the calling point and actual function, either pass by value or pass by reference. When an argument is passed by reference, the caller and the callee use the same variable for the argument. If the function modifies the argument variable, the effect is visible to the caller's variable. When an argument is passed by value, the caller and callee have two independent variables with the same value. If the function modifies the parameter variable, the effect is not visible to the caller. These were the direction specification types you learned in previous session, and out of these, input, output, and inout will pass the argument by value. The keyword ref is used to pass the argument by reference. Here is a function that passing its argument by reference. The ref keyword is used in the argument list of the function named compareVal. If you want to use both passByValue and passByReference arguments in the same function, first you should list all value arguments before the reference arguments. That is, once the ref keyword is used in the argument list, all following arguments should be of type ref. Passing argument by reference would commonly used in test bench coding, especially when the classes and other data structures are modified in tasks and functions. In design coding, mostly you would need only simple functions looking similar to those in C or C++.